Welcome to Hornbill TV, your English news bulletin. I'm Lishini Chesti. Now the headlines. Jamiat Ulema-e-Hind President Maulana Syed Arsad Madani demanded the withdrawal of the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. Madani said the decision to withdraw the farm laws has shown democracy and power of the people is paramount. Farmer leaders on Saturday said that they were yet to withdraw the proposed daily tractor march to Parliament during the winter session. They said further, future course of the agitation will be taken during a meeting on Sunday. Hectic preparations are on for the swearing-in ceremony of Rajasthan new ministers at Governor House on Sunday at 4 p.m. The Mumbai court in an order released today said that there was no evidence of a conspiracy between Aryan Khan, Arbus Merchant and Munmun Damicha to commit drug-related offences. Now for the news in details. A day after Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced withdrawal of three farm laws, Jamiat Ulema-e-Hind President Maulana Arsad Madani demanded the centre to revoke the contentious Citizenship Amendment Act as well.
करीब है इसलिए समझा ये जाता है कि इलेक्शन की बुनियाद के ऊपर इस बिल को वापस लिया गया है हम ये समझते हैं कि ये तो कारोबार से मुताल्लिक चीज़ थी और वो हिंदुस्तान की नेशनलिटी से मुताल्लिक चीज़ है और उसका बड़ा भारी नुकसान मुसलमानों को उठाना पड़ेगा अगर खुदा न खास्ता वो कानून अपनी जगह पर रह गया इसलिए हमारा नज़रिया ये है और हम ये समझते हैं कि चूँकि जनता की ताकत हर ताकत से मुल्क की चाहे वो असम्बली की हो या पार्लियामेंट की हो जनता की ताकत उससे ज़्यादा भारी और भरकम ताकत है इसलिए मुसलमानों के सिलसिले के अंदर भी इस बिल को वापस लिया जाए जो वो बना रहे हैं
Farmer leaders on Saturday said that they were yet to withdraw the proposed daily tractor march to Parliament during the winter session. They said that a call on the future course of the agitation will be taken during a meeting on Sunday. Some new Kisan Morcha core committee member Darshan Pal was quoted as saying by news agency PTI. The SKM, an umbrella body of farmers group, earlier announced that 500 farmers will participate in peaceful tractor marches to the Parliament on every day of the winter session starting from November 29th. The farmers remain undecided on the tractor march even after Prime Minister Narendra Modi's announcement to repeal the farm laws owing to the protests by farmers' bodies at Delhi's borders. The SKM welcomed the stance taken by the government but said that it will wait for the announcement to take effect through due parliamentary procedures. However, the president of Bharatiya Kisan Union, Joginder Sen Ugrahan, said that the tractor march has not been withdrawn. The number of farmers protesting at Delhi's Ghazipur border has gone down as fewer farmers were seen at the protest site on Saturday, a day after Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced the repeal of the three farm laws. However, the farmers are still protesting, demanding a law on minimum support price. Besides MSP, the farmers are also demanding a resolution for the livelihood of the families of the 700 farmers who died while protesting against the three farm laws. The Mumbai court in an order released today said that there was no evidence of a conspiracy between Aryan Khan, Arbus Merchant and Munmun Damicha to commit drug-related offences. The court said that nothing objectionable was found in WhatsApp conversations between them. There is hardly any positive evidence on record to convince this court that all the accused persons with common intention agreed to commit unlawful act, the order read, merely because Aryan Khan, Arbus Merchant and Munmun Damichaw were travelling in the same cruise, that by itself cannot be a foundation for the charge of conspiracy against them, the court explained the justification behind the bail. The HC ordered also said that the Narcotics Control Bureau cannot rely on the alleged confessional statements recorded by the investigating officer as they are not binding. The 24-hour total shutdown called by tribal student bodies, namely the Assam, Assam KSO and Assam Federation units, over the issue of the HAC recommended Manipur Hill areas, EDC Bill 2021 affected normal life in the hill districts of the state on Saturday. The district headquarters, Jaipur Bazaar and its surrounding areas bore a deserted look. Normal businesses were halted at Jaipur Bazaar in response to the shutdown. Shops and other essential grocery stores were all closed. No buses and other public transportation were seen plying on the Chandal Imphal Road. However, emergency services and hospital visits were exempted from the purview of the band. Volunteers of the Kuki Students Organization, which is a federation unit of the Assam, along with the tribal populace, wholeheartedly supported the band, the Assam publicity said. The total shutdown was also effective in Jiribam site approaching from the Taminglong, Churachandpur site and in Ukhrul district. The total shutdown was imposed after no agreeable solution could be had in the official discussions between the state government and the mentioned student organizations on Friday at the Chief Minister's office in the presence of the Chief Minister to discuss the HAC recommended Manipur Hill Areas EDC Bill 2021. An indefinite economic blockade will be imposed along national highways in the state from Monday. Madhya Pradesh city Indore has been ranked India's cleanest city for the fifth time in a row by the center. President Ramnath Kovind on Saturday presented the Swachh Sarvekshan Awards 2021 at New Delhi's Vigyan Bhavan. Gujarat Surat was named the second cleanest city, while Vijayawada in Andhra Pradesh was ranked third in the list. Gujarat's Ahmedabad was conferred with Swachh Sarvekshan Awards for being the country's cleanest cantonment. Meanwhile, Chhattisgarh has been ranked as the country's cleanest state. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Lok Sabha constituency Varanasi bagged the cleanest Ganga Town award.
स्वच्छता अभियान की सफलता के लिए मैं सफाई मित्र और सफाई कर्मी भाइयों बहनों की विशेष रूप से सराहना करता हूं। आज से ही कुछ दिनों पहले राष्ट्रपति भवन में मुझे भरतपुर राजस्थान में वाल्मीकि परिवार में जन्मी और बचपन से ही सफाई के काम में योगदान देने वाली श्रीमती उषा चौमड़ को पद्मश्री से सम्मानित करने का अवसर प्राप्त हुआ था। वे आजकल सुलभ इंटरनेशनल सोशल सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अध्यक्ष पद को सुशोभित कर रही हैं। उन्होंने अभाव, असमानता और कुरीतियों से लड़कर सफल होने का आदर्श उदाहरण प्रस्तुत किया है। उनकी जीवन गाथा से अनेक देशवासी, विशेषकर हमारी बेटियां प्रेरणा प्राप्त कर सकते हैं।
A kacha house was completely gutted in a devastating fire which broke out at Kensa village in Mokokchun district on Saturday, which caused a loss of property estimated to be worth in lakhs. The fire rendered the family of Yarmongba, 47 years old, homeless. According to eyewitnesses' accounts, the fire started at about 9:40 a.m. and within minutes, the flames engulfed the entire house. Fortunately, Kensa villagers were gearing up for Christmas decorations, which led to a gathering of volunteers in huge numbers after the church announced the incident in the PA system to contain the fire. A report from the fire and emergency services of Mokokchung informed that four fire engines were rushed to the site of the incident after receiving information at about 9:56 a.m. The fire was brought under control with assistance from firefighters, the police and local volunteers, updates stated. The cause of the fire is yet to be ascertained. No loss of life was reported. The extra additional commissioner of Ong Pang Pang also visited and assessed the situation. Renowned Naga author Dr. Esther Nkere has urged the students' community to give importance to internal culture as they would do to external culture to live as righteous citizens. She was addressing a cultural program on Saturday at Mount Olive College in Kohima. Kere said that although components of external culture may change, internal culture's values remain within a person until one dies. She emphasized on imbibing the culture of inner beauty, which defines the mind and character of a person. Stating that the internal culture uplifts others, she stressed on the need to develop an excellent internal culture to match the beautiful external culture. Kere maintained how one's internal culture flows out from a place of compassion, tolerance and patience, and reminded how it should be centered in a place of blessing and not criticism. Folk songs and dance performances and cultural themed events were presented by the students during the event. Earlier, the 29th annual Freshers Event of the college was also conducted. Otobo and Ketoy were crowned Mr. and Miss Olivian 2021 respectively. To show solidarity to the Sumihoho Citizens Good Road Campaign, Sataka Baptist Church had a short prayer at the Langki Kiliki River midway of the Gukie Kandinyu Road. The campaign that began on November 11 is underway with about 16 to 20 kilometers being completed. Reverend Kugato Chopi said that new members of the church present there represented the whole church members. He encouraged the Sumihoho members that he would pray that God would talk to the Sumi community like the way he talked to Jeremiah, so that they will be willing to join hands in the campaign. The president of the Sumihoho, Nikito Jimomi, thanked the STBC members for not only giving financial support, but also supporting them throughout prayers. With the objective to renovate and recover this nearly abandoned road, he said, he is very much glad to have the support of the community. He highlighted that they are currently working on 3 to 4 spots with excavators and dumpers. Union Minister of Commerce and Industries and Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution Piyush Goyal, who is on a 2-day visit to Manipur, reached Imphal and was received by Chief Minister Ann Biren Singh, Commerce and Industries Minister T.H. Biswajit Singh and Party President A. Sharda at the Bir Tikendrajit International Airport. He spoke at a press briefing at the party's headquarters. Piyush Goyal said that the contributions made by tribal leaders in India can never be forgotten, for which Prime Minister Narendra Modi declared November 15 as Janjatiya Diwas. Piyush Goyal also said that the state government led by Ann Biren Singh has done a tremendous job in the state. He said it is the collective responsibility of party workers to make sure that the party comes to power again. He said Northeast India has immense potential to be it in the tourism, handicrafts, handloom, agriculture, or in the field of processed food. In the coming days, he believes Manipur will become more developed and become self-reliant.
आत्मनिर्भर भारत का जो देश का सपना है, आत्मनिर्भर भारत का जो प्रधानमंत्री जी का काम है, उसमें मणिपुर एक बहुत बड़ी छलांग लगाएगा। अलग-अलग प्रकार से मणिपुर की विकास यात्रा पिछले 5 साल की हम सब ने देखी है, चाहे वो प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना हो, जिसके तहत 10 लाख अकाउंट मणिपुर में खुले हैं, जिस प्रकार से नेशनल हाईवेज का काम यहाँ पे बढ़ा है, चाहे वो इम्फाल से जिरीबाम हो, इम्फाल से दीमापुर हो, इम्फाल से मोरे हो, इतने कम समय में इतने सारे नेशनल हाईवेज का यहाँ पे काम हुआ। अब दोनों केंद्र और राज्य सरकार और 5 साल तक मिलके मणिपुर के विकास को और तेज गति दे।
BJP MP Varun Gandhi, in a letter to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, asked for strict action taken against Minister of State for Home Ajay Kumar Mishra, whose son Ashish Mishra remains incarcerated for the Lakhimpur Kheri incident, which saw the death of 8 people, including 4 farmers. He has echoed demands made by his cousin, Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, with regard to Mishra. A day after Modi's announcement repealing the tree farm laws, Varun Gandhi, while thanking him for his large-heartedness for the move, said if the step had been taken earlier, the lives of many innocent farmers could have been saved, and that the next step to a full approachment with farmers groups would be according statutory guarantee of minimum support price. Rajasthan Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot expressed concern over the increase in the number of COVID-19 cases in some districts of the state in the last few days. CM Gehlot was reviewing the COVID-19 situation in the state. The Chief Minister said that a letter would be written to the Prime Minister Narendra Modi urging him to allow the booster dose of COVID-19. The Rajasthan CM also said that it has come to the notice that booster doses are being administered in about 35 countries across the world. In such a situation, it is necessary that in order to save the people from the third wave, the central government should issue guidelines to the states soon after taking appropriate decisions regarding the need for booster dose. CM Gehlot said, to learn from the devastation of the second wave and the nature of this virus, the strategy of retesting, tracking and tracing should be implemented strongly, opined CM Ashok Gehlot. He also stressed on the importance of restricting the spread of the virus at the primary level so that the people of the state can be saved from the third wave. The CM directed the concerned authorities to ramp up the testing in Rajasthan, especially in those areas where cases are rising. He also thanked officials to focus on extensive contact tracing. Opposing the state government's decision to table anti-conversion bill in the upcoming winter session, the Archbishop of Bengaluru, Peter Machado, wrote a letter to Karnataka CM Basavaraj Bommai on Friday, urging him to not to promote an undesirable and discriminatory bill in the interest of the peace and harmony in the society.
A strong anti-conversion bill is going to be enacted. And perhaps in the very next assembly that's going to happen in Belgaum, this may be enacted. So we Christians are a little worried about it. And so all over Karnataka, yesterday, 19th of November, we had organized, we were planning to organize rallies and at the same time handing over the memorandum to the Chief Minister to not to go for it. Unfortunately, this being a little of a COVID season, Bangalore, the rains were also predicted. And in some places, the code of conduct also for the MLCs is there.
In the letter, he said that the entire Christian community in Karnataka opposes the anti-conversion bill. He wrote, the entire Christian community in Karnataka opposes the proposal of anti-conversion bill in one voice and questions the need for such an exercise when sufficient laws and court directives are in place to monitor any aberration of the existing laws. Quoting Article 25 and 26 of the Constitution, the Archbishop said that introducing such laws would infringe the rights of the citizens, especially of the minority communities. He also questioned the Karnataka government's order to conduct a survey of both official and non-official Christian missionaries and the institutions and establishments functioning in the state. That's all we have for now. Stay tuned for more news with Hornbill TV.